paste, paste. We'll switch this to gold, silver, blue. And we will hook that up. And so now we'll do the same thing where we did with the doors. Are you by the key? I'm going to hold down the control there. If you are by the key, then proceed. If you're not by the key, don't proceed. Because we are going to do the same thing. We're backing into our solution just like we did with the doors. Custom event. We'll call this custom event take key. All right. So let's just quickly label these. So we'll call this take key event. Near key. And we'll call this like set material. Okay, great. We could move these around just so that they're a little bit more visible all at once if we wanted. But this is pretty much what we've set this all up. Now we just need to add one variable to the door to make it so that the door has a certain type of lock, and then we should be good to go. So let's just do that. Let's close the key blueprint and let's just go back into our door and open that up really quick. So we'll edit the blueprint. Okay, so here we are in the door. I think all we need is a variable that's just like something like a door type or why don't we say like lock type. So we'll make that an integer, and we'll make it public, because we want to be able to set each door. So now when we select each door blueprint, we can see there's a new lock type variable. So we'll set this to a lock type 0, lock type 1, and lock type 2. Three doors, three different types of keys, and we have three different colors of key. Perfect, right? All right, so now we just need to set up our level blueprint so that it all works. So at the end of the door video, we had this door opening sequence. So now pretty much we need to set up, in order for this door to work or not work, we need something in between here to evaluate. You know, do we have the right key in order to make this work? So let's do that. Let's just close that a little bit. We'll use another switch on integer, using a lot of those in this example. There it is. And since this example features three keys, we've set up an array with 0, 1, and 2. And here we are, switch on integer, and we are going to call out the lock type. So I'm going to drag out from the array element and say lock type, and we should be able to, there it is, get lock type, and we'll plug that in. And then depending on what lock, we'll say, will that open the right kind of door? So I made some variables a little bit earlier. Has the gold key, has the silver key. We'll make one more here. Has the blue key. So let's just bring these all in. And we'll just create three branches. And we'll say, okay, if they have the gold key, and the door type is 0, then open the door. If they have the silver key, and the door type is 1, then open the door. If they have the blue key, and the door type is 2, then open the door. All right, let's just make that a little bit neater. Okay, so great. Then let's finish this up by putting together, you know, being able to take the keys. So we'll just say something like, if you're near a key, you hit the T key. Okay, and we'll do the same sort of workflow as we did with the door, which is like, get all actors of class, and what actor was the key blueprint, BP underscore key, and then we'll say for each, and we'll get to hook that up, and we'll say for each, we need to evaluate, are you near the key first? So we'll drag out here and by key. And if you are near the key, then you can take the key. So then we'll say, if that's true, we'll say take the key. That's our custom event. So we need to drag a noodle off of this array element and find take the key in our key blueprint. And we'll now just do a switch on integer. And identify what key type. So we'll say key type, and we'll say switch on integer, and we'll do, since we have three keys for this example, switch on integer, and then we'll just set that all up. So here's the, I created three integer variables, types of keys, and then I'm going to say, okay, well, if the key that we've set is a blue key, a silver key, or a gold key, then we will set those to one. And so we need to, and then we also sort of need to set these variables as well. So we could do it a little bit different. So if they were disposable keys, you could like basically do an add system where like you could collect three or four blue keys, and then as you use the keys, they go away. But we're just going to keep this simple for the example, which has gotten rather long as it is. So let's give it a try. So I'm going to compile, close. We've got our keys in the scene already. So actually, let's move these keys away from the door just so that we've got this a little bit more manageable. So we hit start, we go over now to our doors, I hit E, and the doors don't open anymore. Okay, so we say hit T to try to pick up a key, but we're not near enough to a key, so we get near the gold key, hit T, now we have the gold key, we got some response. Now what door was the gold key? I'm hitting E, it's not this one. It was this one. I hit E. Hey, the door opens. Awesome. Okay, let's pick up the other ones. I'm going to hit the T key. T, I've got the silver key. Hit the E, and now that door opens. And T again. Now I have the blue key. And oh, did I set this door up correctly? Let's do that. Select the door. The lock type needs to be set to 2. So let's just do that for the final T. T and T and there we go. All right, awesome. So thanks so much for watching, and have a good night.